Hello, everyone. I'm Alex Dunn, Assistant Administrator for EPA's Office of Chemical Safety and Pollution Prevention. I'm sorry I couldn't be there in person today, but I'm excited to take this opportunity to address you via video. I'd like to thank the Green Chemistry and Commerce Council for the important and impactful work that you do. Your efforts have helped a diverse group of stakeholders, including us at EPA, make great strides in identifying, developing, and adopting greener chemistry practices across industries, sectors, and supply chains. So let's jump right in. I'm going to start by talking about some of the work we're doing under TSCA and how this work advances sustainability and greener chemistry. Ensuring the safety of chemicals is part of fulfilling EPA's mission of protecting human health and the environment. PBT chemicals are of particular concern because they remain in the environment for significant periods of time and concentrate in the organisms exposed to them. That's why we're working incredibly hard to complete a proposed rule to limit the exposure to 5 PBT chemicals by June. The rule must then be finalized 18 months later. This rule will address any risks to health and the environment from these 5 PBTs and reduce exposures to the extent practicable. TSCA also requires us to review the safety of new chemicals before they're allowed on the market. Completing the review of new chemicals within the statutory deadlines remains one of our top priorities. By assessing new chemical substances before they are manufactured or imported, our new chemicals program is actively carrying out EPA's strategy to prevent pollution before it can occur. One of the ways this is accomplished is through the pre-manufacture notification process, during which industry can voluntarily provide information about the pollution prevention attributes of the new chemical and about steps taken to reduce exposures to or releases of chemical substances. During the PMN review, we carefully consider this information in evaluating potential risks and benefits. We're committed to working with stakeholders to bring new chemistries to market in a way that balances the safety of public health and the environment while allowing America's economy to grow. We're also continuing to work closely with all stakeholders, including those from animal welfare communities, to identify, develop, and integrate new non-animal testing methods in TSCA actions. Last year, on the second anniversary of amended TSCA, we finalized a new strategy to reduce animal testing. The strategy promotes the development and implementation of alternative test methods and strategies to reduce, refine, or replace vertebrate animal testing. Since releasing the strategy, we've had multiple meetings with People for the Ethical Treatment of Animals, or PETA, and the Physicians Committee for Responsible Medicine, or PCRM, to educate the public about new approach methods, or NAMs. Additionally, in our new chemicals program, we're developing an inventory of testing requests that will help us identify, track, and understand the viability of the most commonly used tests in order to better promote the use of NAMs. Now, I'm going to shift my focus to a couple of topics specifically related to greener chemistry. One of our programs you may be familiar with is the Green Chemistry Challenge Awards, which is co-sponsored by the American Chemical Society. For more than 20 years, the Green Chemistry Challenge Awards have been recognizing innovation by American businesses and researchers that promote the benefits of developing and using novel green chemistry in chemical design, manufacture, and use. The innovations recognized by the Green Chemistry Awards span a broad range of sectors in the U.S. economy, including petroleum refining, pharmaceutical manufacturing, military avionics, firefighting foams, agricultural chemicals, and more. Innovations in green chemistry help American businesses compete in global markets by reducing costs through material efficiency, opening new markets for products and services, and transforming waste materials into marketable commodities. The 2019 Green Chemistry Challenge Award Ceremony is planned for June 10th at EPA in DC. Everyone here is invited to attend. Also, keep an eye out for an announcement kicking off the award cycle for next year. Our Pollution Prevention Grant Program also supports innovation and the adoption of greener chemistry. These two-year grants fund state and tribal programs to provide outreach, training, and direct technical assistance to businesses. With 59 active grants currently under this program, we're seeing some exciting work being developed and shared, and continue to believe that engaging states and communities as partners in promoting greener chemistry is a key to our shared future. In closing, thanks again to the Green Chemistry and Commerce Council for organizing this roundtable. I strongly believe that it's important for all of us, whether from a stakeholder group, a chemical company, or government, to embrace these opportunities to come together in whatever way we can to exchange ideas and learn from each other. So let's continue to work together to design new and greener chemicals, minimize waste, and seek out alternative test methods to achieve our goals for a healthy environment.